This is chapter 13, parallelogram, exercise 13A, question number 7. In this question, it says that ABCD is a parallelogram. You have to find the value of X, Y, and Z. Here, ABCD is a parallelogram. You have to find the value of X, Y, and Z. That is angle D, angle C, and angle E. So, we will start with angle B, A, D, plus angle A, D, C is equal to 180 degrees. Why? Because adjacent angle of a parallelogram is 180 degrees. Sum of adjacent angle of a parallelogram is how much? 180 degrees. So, therefore, I can write down as 125 degree plus x equal to 180 degree. From here, find out the value of x. So, from here, x I will get 180 degree minus 125 degree. X is equal to 10 minus 5 is 5. Again, 7 minus 2 is 5. 1 minus 1 is 0. So, the value of x here is how much? 55 degree. Okay, now similarly, I can take angle ADC plus angle DCB equal to how much? 180 degree. Okay, similarly angle ADC is plus angle DCB is equal to how much? 180 degree. So I can write down that down. This is X plus angle Y plus 56 degree equal to 180 degree. If I will add Y plus 50, then total it will become with angle C, that is DCB. So from here, the value of X you are given with 55 degree plus Y plus 56 equal to how much? 180 degree. Similarly, find the value of y here. Y equal to 180 degree minus 55 degree plus 56 degree. Okay? Till here, now we have to find the value of y. So, y is equal to 180 degree. If you will add this, you will get 6 plus 5 is 11. Again, 5 plus 5 is 10 and 1, 11. So, 101 degree. Okay? From here, you will get, subtract the value. You will get y equal to 10 minus 1 is 9. Again, 7 minus 1 is 6. And 1 minus 1 is 0. So, the value of y is 69 degree. Okay? Here, you got the value of x as 55 degree and y as 69 degree. Now according to angle sum property of a parallelogram, what does it say? Angle CEA plus angle EAB plus angle ADC plus angle DCE equal to how much? 360 degree. Here this is equal to, this is forming the quadrilateral. So according to angles and property of a quadrilateral, sum of angles is equal to how much? 360 degrees. So from here we will find out the value of Z. So angles, here angle CEA is how much? Z plus angle EAD is 125 degree plus angle ADC is how much? X degree plus DC is how much? Y degree, that is equal to 360 degree. From here we have to find out the value of Z, because X and Y we know, that is 125 degree. What is the value of X? 55 degree. Value of Y is 69 degree and is equal to 360 degree. From here you have to find the value of Z. So Z equal to how much? We will add Z plus 125 degree. 6 plus 5 is 14, carry 1. Again 6, 1 and 6, 12. 124 degree equal to अगेन z प्लस 5 प्लस 4 इज 9, 2 प्लस 2 इज 4, 1 प्लस 1 इज 2, 249 डिग्री इक्वल टू 360 डिग्री. अगेन z इक्वल टू 360 डिग्री माइनस 249, दैट इज इक्वल टू z इक्वल टू 10 माइनस 9 इज 1, 5 माइनस 4 इज 1 एंड 3 माइनस 2 इज 1. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ z इज 101 डिग्री. ओके, सो हियर y वी गॉट 69 डिग्री, z इज इक्वल टू 101 डिग्री. सो द value of x, y and z is 55 degree, 69 degree and 101 degree. This is the answer. This is question number 8. In this figure it says we have to find the four angle ABCD of a parallelogram ABCD. This is a parallelogram ABCD. We have to find out the angles ABCD of a parallelogram. So first of all, what we will do, we will take angle in a triangle BCD. You know that sum of angles in a triangle is how much? 180 degree. So I can write down this as 5x plus 2x plus 3x equal to how much? 180 degree. So 5x plus 2 is 7, 7 plus 3 is 10. Nx equal to how much? 180 degrees. Yx is equal to 180 degree by 10. So this and this get cancelled. X is equal to 80 degree. Now, as you have seen, if I take angle B is equal to how much? 3 into x. That is 3x. That is 3 into 18 degree. That is 90 degree. 3x, sorry. 5x. So from here, x is equal to 18 degree, we have to find out the value of angle C. So if I take angle C is equal to how much? 5x. Okay, that is 5 into 18 and that is equal to 90 degree. If angle C is 90 degree, angle A will also be how much? 90 degree. Why? Because opposite angles are equal. Why? Because opposite angles are equal. Now we have to find out angle B. We have to find out angle B. If I write down 180 degree minus 90 degree, that is angle B is equal to how much? 90 degree. If angle B is 90 degree, angle D will also be 90 degree, because here these are supplementary angles. Here adjacent angles are supplementary, so angle B is equal to 90 degree and angle D is also equal to 90 degree. This is the answer. This is question number 9. ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD, you are given with a parallelogram. Here C is CE. CE, it bisect angle C. Similarly, angle AF, it bisect angle A. In each of the following, if the statement is true, give a reason for the same. Here you are given with some questions. You have to find out if the statement is true. You have to find out the reason why the statement is true. So the first question is angle A equal to angle C. Means this is saying this angle is equal to this. Okay. So this statement is true because since in a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. In a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. So the second question is angle FAB, means F B. This is half of angle A. This is half of angle A. Yes, it is true, because as you see, here AF is the bisector of angle A, because since AF bisect angle A, and AF is the bisector of angle A, therefore this statement is true. Similarly, for angle DC is half of angle C. You have to see DCE is half of angle C. Why? Because CE is the bisector of angle A. Because CE is the bisector of angle C. In part 4, in part 4, angle FAB means this. FAB is equal to angle DCE. DCE. We have to find out, is it true? So yes, this is true. How? Here you can see angle CEB. This is angle CEB is equal to angle DCE. Is equal to angle DCE. Why this is equal to? Because why these are equal? Because these are alternate angles. Alternate angles. Similarly, angle DCE is equal to angle EAB. Angle DCE is equal to angle EAB. Because in a parallelogram, you see opposite angles are equal. If you can see, opposite angles are equal. So from this, from equation 1 and 2, angle FAB is equal to angle DCE. Means FAB equal to angle DCE. Hence proved. Question, you have just seen angle DC is equal to angle CBE, because these are alternate angles. Similarly, 6th question, angle CB equal to angle FAB, because you know that opposite angle of a parallelogram are equal. And the 7th one is angle CE is angle CE is parallel to CE is parallel to AF. Okay, means this is parallel to this. Yes, these are true, because you can see that angle CEB is equal to angle FAB. Okay, because these angles are equal, so this will be CE will be parallel to AF. This is the answer. You have to see CE is parallel to AF. Why? Because here corresponding angles are equal, and here you can see angle CEB will be equal to angle FAB, and these both are corresponding angles, therefore CE will be parallel to AF, and this is true. And the reason behind this, because corresponding angles are equal, and therefore CEB is equal to angle FAB. CEB is equal to FAB. Thank you.